Welcome to installment number 225 of the Mitzvahs as enumerated by Maimonides, the Rambam. Yesterday we started speaking about positive commandment 98, which discusses the requirements for a food or a drink to have the capability of becoming impure. And we said there were two big ones. Number one, it needed to be actual food. It needed to be edible. It can't just be any, you know, random thing. It needs to be something that you can eat. Number two, some form of liquid must have been splashed on it, or must have been washed with it, because this shows that this food was actually planned to be eaten and ready to be eaten. And as we spoke yesterday, there are seven liquids. It's not just water, but there are seven liquids that, if placed on this food, has the ability for it to be rendered impure. And these are known by the acronym of Yad Shochat Dam. The letter stand for Yayin, which is wine, Dalet, which is dam, which is blood. The Shin is for Shemen, which is oil. The Ches is for Chalav, which is milk. Shochat, the Tes, is Tal, which is dew. Dam is Dvash and Mayim, honey and water. So if any of these seven liquids are placed on this food, then it has the ability of turning impure. And today we add one more level on top of that, and this is that it can't just be anybody that poured this liquid on the food, but it must be the owner of the food. The owner of the food who is planning on eating it. It can't just be that, you know, you stop in a store and the apple was washed and therefore it has the ability to be impure. No, the owner, the person who bought the apple, has to have washed it in preparation to eat it. And today we have an interesting discussion about this concept of the impurity in food. And as you might know, we wash our hands before eating bread, and it is exactly for this reason, so that we should not pass on the impurity that is in our hands onto our food. And therefore, we wash our hands. And we are told that we don't always have to wash our hands, only if we are eating a minimum of 2 ounces. And not only does it have to be a minimum of 2 ounces, but it must also be eaten in a certain time frame. It must be eaten within 6 or 7 minutes. That each ounce has about 6 or 7 minutes that it needs to be eaten. And if we are going to be eating this amount of food, we must wash our hands. Of course, we know that there are types of bread called mezaynas bread, which is the bread that we don't have to wash. We don't make the bracha of hamotzi on it. And this is because it's made with juice or apple juice and not straight up flour and water. And so it's considered like, you know, not a proper meal. When you're going to sit down to a proper meal, you'll wash your hands and have bread. However, if you're going to have this type of mezaynas bread that is made with juice, and thus you don't have to wash on it. However, if it's going to be a meal and it's going to be considered a full-on meal for you, then you should indeed wash your hands. And of course, we do this in preparation to be ready, that on that day when that great shofar blows and Mashiach's arrival is upon us, we will be ready and we will know how to purify ourselves in order to enter the temple and to be a part of all the action. May it be speedily in our days. Have a wonderful day.